Yeah, and I do that too, especially on my main site. So I was really worried about it. So on my main site, I have it on the sidebar. I have it in a short coded, highlighted box where I have kind of the disclaimer, as well as I also put in my image credit in there as well. Just kind of cover two bases there. And then I also have it in the footer, in a footer widget as well. So,
It's all over. People see it.
really err on the side of caution.
After you replied back, how long did it take to get a reply back from Amazon?
They never really replied. I saw the warning of death get removed from the Amazon Associates account. I was just like, okay, cool, that's good. And then like 2 days after they removed it, I got an email, very general, very vague. Thank you for it didn't even say like thank you for addressing these issues or anything. It was like just thank you basically. I don't remember, but it was just like, okay, thanks.
That sounds right. That's exactly what I got. Mine was about 2 weeks. I didn't hear anything for 2 weeks, and eventually I got the email. Thanks, we completed the audit, basically. And after that, everything was fine. So it's really great that you were given a couple URLs as an example. I don't know if that's super common, but it probably made it a lot easier to at least address the issues and know like where they were. So,
And
man.
I probably took off some content that probably was compliant. Like I trimmed off probably five, 6 pages that I could have kept. But again, erring on the side of caution. And again, this is part of my livelihood. So.
And you recently launched a YouTube channel, and I know one of the videos you have is about this audit, so people could check that out. But why don't you tell us a little about the YouTube channel and why you decided to start it?
Sure. It's something. So I started a YouTube channel. As of the time of this interview, I have I think 4 videos and like 9 subscribers. So, lots going on there. But yeah, something I've been kind of thinking about for a long time. Seeing people like yourself and WP Eagle and Carl, Amelia, all these people kind of in the space that are, and I saw there's some things I have to contribute just in terms of my own experience with niche sites and also kind of where I live. So I was going to share Hawaii and share kind of my unique perspective, and my big hobby is bodyboarding, surfing in the ocean. So I felt I could kind of combine all of those and just some kind of YouTube channel. So that's
Awesome. It's exciting. I know there's a lot of different directions you can go in it with like really focusing heavy on the marketing part or even on the vlogging part or like the travel aspect and stuff like that. So where do you have like an area that you're gonna lean, or you just kind of cover everything and see what's working out for you?
It's one of those things. Obviously it's a work in progress. Again, someone like me who's super ADD, it's hard to focus on just really anything. So really what I'm trying to do with the YouTube channel is to use it as a tool to help me focus and kind of help this all be synergistic. So I kind of want to document my journey with niche sites, and that's pretty much kind of where I'm going to go. And then I can do that from anywhere, from Hawaii. As I, the video I did on the Amazon audit is I was walking and doing a hike on a trail, on a beautiful trail. So just it's also kind of a catalyst to help me get out more. In COVID times, it's important just to get outside and not drive yourself crazy. So I felt if I'm doing a YouTube channel from Hawaii, I have to share Hawaii, right? So that's part of it. So.
Awesome. Well, everyone, check out Bo's channel over there. We'll get links to the specific video and the channel in general. So, anything else going on with the site that you're, looking forward to that I forgot to ask you about?
No, it's just like I said, it's the big content push is kind of where I'm going with this, and then trying to, and I think I said this in the last interview and I didn't get to it, and that's just scaling kind of myself and taking a more kind of the role of a project manager and a boss rather than the person doing all of the work. So getting that content service is going to be big for me, that pushes out good content, or hiring more writers, getting more content, and then also getting a WordPress content manager, someone to actually post the content. those are my big goals. So before the end of the year, and then again, kind of document it all on YouTube. So
very cool. And I'll tell you that one of the good things with a YouTube channel or a blog or anything where you're documenting, even if it doesn't work out, you have a story to tell. So, yeah. I mean, we want it to work out, but you know, even if the traffic goes down or like you run into some issues with a writer or whatever, you can share that story and let people know that it happens to everyone. So